Good morning. Today is the 24th Sunday in the Ordinary Time, and the readings are found on page 249. 249.
Our opening song is number 714. Gather us in, number 714.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator and Ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Wrath and anger are hateful things, yet the sinner hugs them tight. The vengeful will suffer the Lord's vengeance, for he remembers their sins in detail. Forgive your neighbor's injustice, then when you pray, your own sins will be forgiven. Could anyone nourish anger against another and expect healing from the Lord? Could anyone refuse mercy to another like himself? Can he seek pardon for his own sins? If one who is but flesh cherishes wrath, who will forgive his sins? Remember your last days. Set enmity aside. Remember death and decay and cease from sin. Think of the commandments. Hate not your neighbor. Remember the Most High's covenant and overlook faults. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
He pardons all your iniquities, heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction, crowns you with kindness and compassion.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
He will not always chide, nor does he keep his wrath forever. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
For as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing is kindness toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he put our transgressions from us.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, none of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be the Lord of both the dead and the living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
A new commandment, says the Lord, love one another as I have loved you. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Peter approached Jesus and asked him, Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive? As many as 7 times? Jesus answered, I say to you, not 7 times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought before him, owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold along with his wife, his children, and all his property in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down, did him homage, and said, be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full. Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go and forgave him the loan. When that servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, pay back what you owe. Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, be patient with me, and I will pay you back. But he refused. Instead, he had the fellow servant put into prison until he paid back the debt. Now, when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, you wicked servant, I forgave you your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servant as I had pity on you? Then in anger, his master handed him over to his torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you unless each of you forgives your brother from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In order for us to appreciate the Word of God for this Sunday, we'll briefly glance back to last Sunday's Gospel especially, because today's Gospel is continuation of what we heard last week and is connected. Remember in last week's gospel, Jesus gave instructions how to resolve conflicts and offenses. First step, person to person. If that fails, go to the second step, bring a third party in. And if the offender persists and doesn't change his ways, then the person will be handed over to the judgment of the church, which has the power to separate the offender until he comes to his senses. And then Jesus did something astonishing. He said to Peter and to the disciples, I give you the keys of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and so forth and so forth. We continue on that theme today. Peter naturally was impressed by the power that Jesus was giving him, so he said to Jesus, well, how often should I forgive? 7 times? Number seven was the magic number in the Bible. And Jesus says, not seven times, but 70 times seven, which means unlimited number of times. And then Jesus proceeds to tell this interesting parable of someone who was brought in to a king. The person owed a tremendous amount of money. In other translations, we are told that he owed 10,000 talents. The word talents in the Bible doesn't mean anything like it does for us. Natural abilities. It was a technical word to quantify precious metals. 10,000 talents, whether of gold or silver. It was such an enormous amount of debt that the listeners clearly understood that no human being could pay such a debt off. And as the story develops, the debtor asks the master, please let me have some time so that I can try to pay back. But the Lord, with one pen, he says, I understand. Your debt is canceled. Go in peace. Well, things begin to happen. As he was leaving, the big debtor, now freed, he met another fellow servant who owed him a time fraction of the money. And he began to harangue him, pay back now, and on and on. And the other man, again, he says, please, give me just a little bit time and I will pay everything back. But the first fellow was, he will have none of it. And he proceeded and started to liquidate the person's assets for the debt. It came back to the Lord, to the master, what has happened. And there was hell to pay. You see, the king's astonishing compassion dovetails with the equally astonishing stupidity and moral depravity of the big debtor, which is illustrated towards a fellow debtor. Huge debt, petty debt. The first debtor was clearly possessed of greed and hypocrisy. He didn't learn the lesson of gratitude or compassion or mercy that was extended to him by the master just a short time before. Ultimately, the master on that occasion, and that was the Jesus point, the master brought to forth justice. Justice. As Jesus would say, God's going to treat you the same way that you treat your fellow debtors. We as human beings have a great difficulty quantifying God's mercy toward us. How many times in the course of our lives have we said act of contrition or some other prayer telling God that we regret, that we're sorry for our sins? In human terms, God could whack us to nothing, But God is not human. His mercy is unlimited because he's God. Even when Jesus tells us that he came on earth for our sake, to forgive us our sins, it doesn't go much below our skin because we're human. We have no measuring instrument to quantify God's mercy and forgiveness. The solution is we simply believe because Jesus tells us so, and we are invited to be grateful and to try to order our lives more justly so that we can become somewhat worthy of God's mercy and forgiveness. If we glance at today's first reading, it expresses a tremendous, what we would say today, it expresses a tremendous psychological truth. It's the subject of so much counseling. It says, the sinner hugs wrath and anger tightly. The sinner hugs wrath and anger tightly. On thinking about it, it's probably, it may be, in a sense, easier to forgive big things, big offenses against us, than to have the grace of forgiving petty, everyday things. I'm amazed sometimes, as in programs, when people have suffered a huge injustice or someone close to them was killed, and on, and they will say publicly, I forgive that person who killed my brother or sister, my parent, and so forth. What that person is saying is not a rational explanation. I think it's the result of God's grace. God's grace for which the person has asked and is now able to forgive. The importance of forgiving is a theme that Jesus keeps returning time after time. And he clearly tells us, unless you really try to forgive the offenses of other people, God will treat you and me in the same way on the judgment day. To forgive and be compassionate when we are so deeply offended, we need the help of other people, and that's why we talk to one another about it. But that's not all. I think that in those cases and others, there has to be an appeal to the higher power, the appeal to the Holy Spirit to give us the grace to wash away from our minds and memories the hurts and insults and all the rest, so that with his help, we can begin to experience the forgiveness that God extends to us, so that we may be able to do the same to each other. And so today, we pray for one another that we may have God's power and grace to do likewise. Amen. Please rise. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Brothers and sisters, trusting in God's mercy and compassion, we offer our prayers and petitions. As we say, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the church. May the Lord bless her and keep her safe from all evil. We pray to the Lord. For harmony and justice in our nation and across the world, may the Prince of Peace dwell in the hearts of all. We pray to the Lord. For all who are holding on to past hurts and grievances, may the Lord give them the grace to forgive. We pray to the Lord. For our parish, may the Lord fill us with love and truth and gratitude and guide us in the ways of wisdom. We pray to the Lord. For those who are hateful and violent, may they be open to the Lord's healing presence. We pray to the Lord. For all the sick, the suffering, and the neglected, we pray to the Lord. For our new bishop, who will be installed this Monday as the chief shepherd of our diocese, we pray to the Lord. For our beloved dead, that they may know the loving embrace of our merciful Father, we pray to the Lord. And for our petitions in the silence of our hearts. Father of mercy and compassion, look beyond our sins and hear the prayers we offer you with contrite and repentant hearts. We ask this as we ask everything through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our offertory song is number 709, Prayer of St. Francis, number 709.
There is a tree of parted gold.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these, your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come in glory. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Jakob, Maria, Rado, and all the deceased of the Zakel families, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who were united with your Son in death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, our departed parishioners, benefactors, family members, friends, souls in purgatory, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Spouse St. Joseph, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
With faith and confidence, we pray to Heavenly Father as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. Please offer each other a sign of God's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us. This is Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. the body of Christ.
The communion song is number 564, One Bread, One Body, number 564.
Please turn to page 789. Prayer to St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do you, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the divine power thrust into hell, Satan and all the other evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Prayer to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Heart of Jesus, aflame with love for us, have mercy on us. Heart of Jesus, source of justice and love, have mercy on us. Heart of Jesus, treasure house of wisdom and knowledge, have mercy on us. Heart of Jesus, in whom there dwells the fullness of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, gentle and humble of heart, touch our hearts and make them like your own. Amen. Let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God bless you with every heavenly blessing, make you always holy and pure in his sight, pour out in abundance upon you the riches of his glory, and teach you with the words of truth. May he instruct you in the gospel of salvation and ever endow you with fraternal charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace and have a blessed Sunday.
Thanks be to God. The closing song is number 724. Sent forth by God's blessing, number 724.
Sent forth by God's blessing, our true faith confessing, the people of God from his dwelling take leave. God's sacrifice ended, oh, now be extended the fruits of this mass in all hearts who believe. The seed of Christ's teaching, our inner souls reaching, shall blossom in action for God and for all. His grace shall incite us, his love shall unite us to further God's kingdom and answer his call. With praise and thanksgiving to God who is living, the tasks of our everyday life we embrace, our faith ever sharing, in love ever caring, we claim as our neighbor all those of each race. One bread that has fed us, one light that has led us, unite us as one in his life that we share. Then may all the living with praise and thanksgiving